coming, friend.
Look at him. Turncoat. Makes me bloody ill to think on how many times I've put up with Horny Gold and his self-righteous shite.
Verily, you are a man of principle, Captain Horny Gold. A man I believe I can trust with my best ideas.
Faith, and we'll survive this, Charles, with our pride intact.
Well, that's confidence. You brewed a plan I might get a taste of?
Nassau is over, that's plain to see. I say we skip out tonight and regroup at my compound.
Fair enough. What's your angle?
The Brits have brought their supplies ashore, see? If we nick some gunpowder and pine pitch, we can build a fire ship and send it straight at the blockade, blasting it to smithereens.
Aye. We'll use Rackham's ship. Ain't a capable captain.
My conscience is clear.
Right. When you get the gunpowder, I'll secure the pine pitch.
Thank you. wants energy for the work.
The thrifty man's refuge here. All my prices are trifling.
I am having many things for to delight you, my friend.
Thank you.
Bastards in me sights!
Slippery bastard in sight, boys. There he is!
Go away, Bondrel. Please.
Last one and for your meat.
I just have to pull the trigger.
Shit! Alarm! Alarm! Stop it! Cut him off!
I've got a lovely clear shot. I just have to pull the trigger. I've got a clear shot, man.
I think I can hit him! I've got him in my sight!
Thank you.
Bastards and mistakes!
Ugh!
try to keep us any trouble.
Come on, boys, you're lagging.
It's this bloody amp.
Lieutenant.
Aye, sir.
The Commodore fears a revolt is nigh. His orders are to sink every goddamn pirate ship now anchored in that harbor, tonight.
It's by the Governor's wishes, sir.
This is a direct order, soldier. You will take position on the grounded galleon and await the Commodore's further orders. Is that clear?
Aye, sir.
The conniving bastard. Someone ought to slit the Commodore's throat before he gets a chance to bar those orders.
You think so?
We're dead in the water otherwise.
All right, I'll kill him.
Your brains are baked. I won't take no part in killing the Commodore. Not one of the King's men.
We can't risk our good fortune. I'll be waiting for you.
Between them two, Rogers and Chamberlain, what's the issue?
Commodore don't think much of civilians, are. And there's a rumor going around that Rogers is some kind of a Jacobite, or worse, that he's a Catholic.
Oh, I could think of worse.
You!
Stay back if you know what's good for you.
With you.
Sir, we have information for the Commodore, an urgent matter.
Carry on.
Looks a sour blood between them two, Rogers and Chamberlain. What's the issue?
Commodore doesn't want to watch his civilians, there. There's a rumor going around that Rogers is some kind of Jacobite, or worse, that he's a Catholic.
Oh, I could think of worse.
Commodore, in truth. He's a serious chap. No sense of humor.
We'll keep them busy.
All right. I can lead you through.
Take positions and prepare to decamp on the Commodore's order.
Stop. Stop now.
I have your life.
This'll get him.
Tumble up there, men! Tumble up all! Prepare to lose the topsails!
That's right! Lay aloft, quick as you please!
Already forward? Wait for my signal, please!
The Governor's given us a pardon, Commodore. Don't a man's word mean anything in these times?
Has syphilis clouded your mind? Why scratch and claw to protect such squalor? Your parasites feeding off the industry of honest men.
Much like King George in that respect.
Know your place, peasant! You may have taken my life, but you have not improved your own by any measure.
Does some purpose keep you talking?
If not for that heathen, Governor Rogers, I'd have seen you hanged from your own cross trees. Worm. All of you.
futile. You can't that.
Come back. He's mine.